Ringo, Chaka Cole, yeah. Okay, where are we in the world? Ifo Nimba Olam. Okay, we are in the Smecha program in Yoredea Sadik Chet, paragraph Chet. Kal mitbatel b'tish'a v'chamishim. Right, we spoke about Khal. We had a whole Siman, right? Siman Tzadik, I believe, about Khal. So here we go again. Remember what is Khal? The breast of the animal that have the milk, right? Have the milk inside. So that's like a place that the milk and the meat meets together, right?
Yeah.
Rabbi Nachman told his servants, put zavikula khal, put to his wife that she wanted to taste of meat and dairy together. Wow. Said like put khal on the barbecue. Yeah. So we had the whole discussion of how to make the khal kosher. But if it was not done and it's still prohibited, so how much you need to nullify the khal? Says the Shulchan Aruch, only 59. Yeah. Tish'a v'chamishim. Why 59 is enough? Because khal min haminyan. Yeah. The khal. Mishnah in Hulin, that Khal is in 60, but Khal is part of the 60. So you need another 59 besides of the Khal. Yeah?
Okay.
Okay.
So you need another 59?
You need the Khal plus 59 volumes as the Khal, and then the Khal that is prohibited becomes to be permitted because the milk that was inside becomes to be nullified.
The khal is like considered like 1% of it, or like,
it's one out of the 60. So yeah. You need another 59 like it.
Oh, okay.
Says the Rama, kol isurim noagim bazman hazeh kulam mibatlim b'shishim milvad chametz v'pesach v'yein nesach. Says the Rama, all the things that are prohibited in this time, it all gets nullified in 60, besides chametz in Pesach and the yei nesach, which is a wine that was offered for idol worshiping. Kashen in Berbal Chotem, like we will discuss about it in length, where like in those sections of the Shulchan Aruch. But she'isur eino noten tam bakdera, as long as that thing that is prohibited doesn't give taste in the pot. אבל אם נותן טעם באותה גדרה, if it does give taste in the pot, הוא אסור מצד עצמו. So then there is a prohibition because of the taste, אפילו באלף לא בטל. And even if you have 1,000 times the amount of the prohibition, it will not be nullified. שמרגישים טעמו, when you feel that taste. Okay? לכן מלח ותבלין כמדברים דאבדי לטעמה. So salt, or spices that are things that are there to give taste, if it is prohibited for itself, okay, so then they cannot be nullified in 60 because you can feel the taste even more than that, right? Okay. Says the very Tev,
you'd
had.
Then it doesn't work, right?
It's not possible for us to have something that have a taste of something that is prohibited and it will be permitted. Uh-huh. If it has a taste of something that is prohibited, it's prohibited. Uh-huh. Okay?
Yeah.
Be'eritev yudchet, anogim. Perush ben shel Torah, ben shel divrehem. So it can be Torah prohibitions or rabbinical prohibitions. Same thing, same way. Yutet atzmam, the prohibitions of itself. Kegon tavlin shel avodat kohavim ve shel olah. So what will be spices that are prohibited for themselves? So the Baal HaTov gives an example. If that spices were offered for idol worshiping, like we spoke about, I believe, yesterday, right? Or no, a couple of days ago, right? If it was offered for an idol, yeah, like in India or whatever, or like in the Far East, that they making like a food offering for the idol worshiping. So the leftovers of that offering is prohibited because of idol worshiping, right? Ola. You remember what is Ola?
Yes, the
first 3 years of the fruits of the tree
are
Ola, as prohibited. Yeah. Kaotze bo afilu en isurim ela midrabanan lapuki im hem rak bluim misu. So something like that is prohibited mihamat atzman because of itself. Doesn't matter if it's Torah or rabbinical prohibition, but it comes to exclude a case that it is prohibited because of something else, because it is observed taste of something else. Atam shehmiru betavlin, the reason that they are stringent about the spices lefishim minestam, because of in a normal case, noten tam be'elef, it gives taste 1,000 times more than its own value, its own volume. Yeah, it doesn't have to be like exactly 1,000, but the idea is more than 60. לפי זה איך הידוע בבירור שנותן טעם, but if it is very clear that it didn't give taste, כגון שנפר על קורט אחד של מלח או תבלין איורה גדולה, מותר. So according to that, if you know that it didn't give taste, if there was like a tiny bit that fell into a big pot, so you know that it didn't give taste, how much taste you can have like from a tiny bit of spices, yeah. So there is a limit, yeah, maybe more than 60, but it's not like so much, yeah. The fact is that if you're making a big pot, you want the spices to give taste. So you have to put like a certain quantity of spices, otherwise you won't have the taste, right? So obviously it's limited. So according to that, it will be permitted in a case like that, right? ועסק בדורת רדד, אפילו נפל מלך ודבלין לדבר שווה בשמו, אפילו אחי כיוון דחלוק בטעמה לא בטיל. Okay, and now we're getting back to the argument that we discussed between the Mechaber and the Rama, between the Rama and the Shach, about the definition of min b'mino or min b'sheino mino, that we said that according to the Rama, it goes by the name, and according to the Shach, and that's the Halacha, it goes by the taste, right? So also here, he says that Torat Chatat is the Rama, right? So the Torat Chatat, he says that if you have a salt or spice that falls into something that have the same name, so even though it has a different taste, it will not be nullified, right? Because it's min b'mino, right?
Same like two types of the same meat, like you have kosher beef and treif beef or something, like is that considered min b'mino?
Okay, so here is an example that it's also the name and also the taste,
okay.
Right? And you feel by the taste if it's kosher or not kosher meat. So it doesn't make a difference in the taste, as far as I know, right? So, but let's say if you have a different kind of meat, I'm not sure exactly what kind of what will be the. Yeah, but that they give like they call it in a different name,
okay.
Right? When somebody goes to a non-kosher restaurant, they ask him, you want this kind of meat or that kind of meat? Wow. They're not calling it the same name.
Oh, so let's say like you have two of the...
It's not so simple to find like something like that. Right?
Yeah.
Anyhow.
So what if something falls that's shallow? The bottle of the shishim?
Yeah. So.
It has the equal taste to the.
But if it has the same taste, it will be nullified in 60. Okay? כתב באיסור בהתר, דהיין לא בטל, אפילו באלף, היינו מדרבנן. ואם אינו יודע אם מרגישים טעמו או לא, מתיר בקאי גוונה. So he says that the... When we say that something is not nullified in 1,000, it means it's a rabbinical stringency. Okay? It's a rabbinical stringency. So if you don't know if there is a taste or there's no taste, it will be permitted according to that because it's a fact the rabbanan. Okay? מתיר בקאי גוונא, ברור זו, גם אתה לאכילו, לא בדוק חובים. Okay, now, what about letting a non-Jew to taste it according to that? So he said, there is a side to be to permit it. You don't know, you need to have someone that will taste it for you. So the only way to do it is to give it to a non-Jew. Okay? Now, we know that the Rama doesn't rely on a tasting of a non-Jew, right? So that's permission is only for Sfaradim. But, okay, there is a side like that. כתב אתה אז, וצריך עיון לעניין שומן של איסור שנפל למאכל. Prohibited fat that fell into something that you eat. מה יהיה בטל? Why would it be nullified? Beshishim, in 60. Aletam avid. It's there to give taste. Vetiretz b'shem isur v'eter. Ze lo mikri tam b'ze el hadavar harif. Isur v'eter says, it's not a real taste. It's something that is like spicy. Ze lo mikri tam b'ze el hadavar harif. Something that is spicy, that's something that gives like taste in this case. Lo shuman, but something that is just fatty, that's not the taste. Yeah? Av shegam hu mat'im ha-ma'achal hu mantiko, even though something like the fat makes the food to be more tasty, mikol makom en irgash kol kach kmo davar chariv, but it doesn't have so much sense like spicy. משומח כתב כאן רמה כגון מלח ותבלין. That's why the Rama says here that it's like a spicy food or salty food. Okay? אין אור חיים סימן תף קוף יוד גימל. לשם לא מהני 60. So there... the 60 will not help you. Aval gav de ino davar harif, even though it's not spicy. So lomar de shani adam sheyesh tama vechazuta gabei beitza shelibnu bo ma'achal. Okay, so there it's something else, it's different because even though it's not spicy, but it will be prohibited. So he's explaining why there you have this special case. So he says, it's a, you have the taste. Shalom Aleichem. Shalom Aleichem. Okay. Shama, do you want to try to help him to get Datu Tvuna over there? So the food is... Okay, so we're talking about like food, like bread, that there is an egg on top. You know, they're doing it on the like a challah sometimes. They put like egg on top of the challah.
Yeah.
right?
Yeah.
So that's what he's talking about over there. So the question is that why it's not an LFI? So he's explaining because that egg on top of the bread is something that is visible. You can see that. Yeah. It's not like it's not about the taste so much. It's that it's something that like you look on that and you see. So if that shiny thing is prohibited, so it even if there is like more than 60, it will still be prohibited because you can see that prohibition on top.
Wow.
Yeah. For example, the Arabs here in the that they are selling like those like breads with sesame on top, right?
Yeah.
So I don't know if it's true. It's not. Somebody said in the past that he got like their secret of how they do that special bread because eggs, to put egg on top and then to put the sesame, it's costly, right? The eggs are costly, cost a lot of money.
Yeah.
So instead of using the eggs, they taking like a gelatin of bones that they like, they cook bones, they make like soup of bones, and then shalom aleichem. They make a soup of bones, and then they smear it on top of the bread that the sesame will stack on it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So that something like that is prohibited, obviously, because the bones that they are using is bones of meat that was not kosher meat.
Wow.
Yeah. So that's a good example for us, something that is practical, that is happening. Yeah. So even if you have like in the bread more than 60, then the amount of the forbidden gelatin that they're putting on top, but it will not be nullified because it's something that is visible. You look on the bread and you see it's like shiny on top. It's like it has this extra like benefit of the look, extra look of it. That makes it that it will be prohibited. Okay, that's what he's saying here. But here we're not talking about something that is visible, so that's why we're talking about the taste and the amount of 60 or 1,000 or whatever it is. Tavod shuman basar shenafal letoch ma'achal chalav batel b'shishim. A fat of meat that fell into a milk, it is nullified in 60, kivan she'ena isur mitzad atzmo, because the prohibition is not coming because of the mixture. Okay? Tet. Kderash yesh banun tet zeiteim eiter. You have a bowl, a pot, of 59 kazait of something that is permitted. Menaflu bashnei zitim, echad shel dam veechad shel chelev. And you have there two kazaitim of two different prohibitions that fell inside into that pot. Kol echad mitzteref im anuntet shel eter levatel chavero. Okay, that's amazing. Each one of them joins together with the 59 permitted kazaitim to nullify the other prohibition. Okay?
49.
You have 59 kazaits of heter, of permission. Yeah? And then you have kazait of blood and kazait of forbidden fat that fell inside. So what would you say? There's more, the prohibition is not nullified in 60. So the Shulchan Aruch nei? No, why not? Because I have 60 to nullify the blood, and I have 60 to nullify the forbidden fat. Yeah?
Yeah.
The kazait of the blood helps me to nullify the right.
So does that mean that now you have? So what does that mean exactly?
I have kazait of the forbidden fat,
yeah,
that joins together with the 59 kazaitim of permission,
okay,
to nullify the one kazait of blood. And I'm using the kazait of blood to join with the 59 kazaitim of heter of permission to nullify the kazait of the forbidden fet. So I do have 60 to nullify each one of the kazaits of the prohibition, because it's two different kinds of prohibitions, two different tastes.
Okay.
So I have 60 to nullify each one of them. So doesn't in the neither of them gives taste to the pot.
But here we only have, I mean, that 59 kazaitim is like a unit of, you know, now you need within those 59, you need now shishim in order to at least shishim to nullify the.
That's the Hava Amina. But the chiddush is that the kazait of the prohibition.
Yeah.
Joins with the permission to nullify the other kind of prohibition.
So now you have like 60.
So I have 60 to nullify each one of the different kinds of the prohibition.
So what's the prohibition here? The chela.
I have two kinds of prohibitions. One is blood, and one is forbidden fat.
But because there's zaysim of dam and zaysim of kolav, you mix those two together.
Both of them fell into the pot.
Right.
Not that I mixed it together.
No, but
both of them fell into the pot.
They come together.
Fell together into the pot.
And the
pot is permitted.
Because you use those two zaysim to.
I use each one of them to nullify his friend.
So you take aside the dam and the chelov, and you join just the zayas part of it, right? Like you have the two zaysim. You're joining together to make to add on to the 60.
Yeah.
The two.
I'm looking now on the prohibition of blood. I have kazait of blood here in this pot. Do I have 60 to nullify that kazait of blood? What's the answer?
Yeah.
Yes, I do. I have 59 of permission plus one kazait of forbidden fat. So I have 60 to nullify the taste of the blood. I'm looking now on the kazait of the forbidden fat. Do I have 60 to nullify that? Yes. How so? 59 of permission, one kazait of blood. Okay. So there's no taste of prohibition here.
Right. And so that 1% of blood is inspired together with the 59, or
yeah, basically.
But it's a kazait of blood. Like it's
so that's the chiddush.
That's the chiddush. That you take that kazait. Use it as
like it was permission for the other prohibition. That prohibition is like permission to nullify it.
That's two different types, right?
Right, exactly. Okay, and that's another chidush. Okay, if you have 29 kazaits of permission and one kazait of forbidden fat fell inside, and another pot of 30 of permission and fell inside kazait of blood, and then those two pots got mixed together, says the Shulchan Aruch, mutar, it will be permitted. Okay. Says the Rama, וכל שכן בבית כזיתים, אחד של גבינה, אחד של בשר, וכל אחד מבטל חברו. And how much more so, that's interesting, קל וחומר. How much more so, in two כזיתים of cheese, one of meat, that each one will nullify the other. Now, usually, the cheese and the meat are making a new prohibition. So it will be a real prohibition here of basar v'chalav, two kazeitim. But here no, because it didn't got together before to be like chalas shem of isu that it will be prohibited. It fell into the pot, so each one is nullifying the other, and there's no prohibition. It's only permitted. Let's see the beritel kaf, mitzaref. שטעם דם וחלב אינו שווה. The taste of the blood and חלב. The taste of the blood and the prohibited fat is not equal. הרי נתבטל טעם החלב ב-60. So the טעם החלב ב-60. So the taste of the forbidden fat is nullified in 60. וטעם אדם, שאימן also the taste of the blood is nullified in 60. דמה לי איסור, מבטל איסור, מה לי יותר מבטל איסור. Why do I care if it is something that is prohibited, that is nullifying the prohibited, or permission that is nullifying the prohibited? רק שיתבטל טעם האיסור, the whole thing that I care is that it will nullify the taste of that is prohibited. But lo yeh lo od koach liten tam b'eter, that you will not have strength to put in that taste of permission anymore. Okay?
What should make a difference if you have, I don't understand this, what's the difference if you have?
I don't care what made the taste of the, that of the prohibited, the prohibited taste to be nullified. I don't care how it got nullified. The point is that it got nullified and now there's no taste of, or that is prohibited.
Right.
That's it. כף א', בשוגג. אבל במזיד דבר דינו בסימן צדיק ת', אוקיי? So if it got mixed in a mistake, so then it makes the, it becomes to be permitted. But if it was purposely mixed, so that will be a different thing that we'll discuss in the next סימן צדיק ת'. כתב בתז, דזה למען דליד לחנן בשאר איסורי. תז is commenting that obviously that permission is only to the Shulchan Aruch that doesn't hold Hanan in other prohibitions. אבל לפי מה דקיים עלינו אמרים לחנן בכל האיסורים, but according to the Ashkenaz custom to say Hanan in all the prohibitions, גם זה אתה עובד אסור, also that mixture is prohibited. Why? וכבר נעשה נבלה קודם אתה עובד, because it already got prohibited, like nevela, like prohibited before it got mixed, the two pots together. שר כתב גם לדעת רמה מצינו דין זה לעניין לך בלך. The Rama said that we found this halacha for two things that are liquids, two liquids. זה לא אמרין אין חנן בהפסד מרובה. That in two liquids there is a leniency not to say חנן when it's a big loss, even according to the Ashkenazim. Yeah? Liquids of other prohibitions besides milk and meat. הדליל סימן צדיק בד, סעיף ד' אינמי דרמה אזי לתעמד, הסביר אליהם נתווסף על האיסור בשוגג קודם שנודע תערובת, לא אמרים לנחנן. Okay? There's another possibility, says the שח. According to the רמה, that he have a rule that if those things got together mixed in a mistake without no one knowing about the prohibition, so then there's no Hanan, because the Hanan comes when you know about the mixture of the prohibition. So if you didn't know about it and the two pots got mixed, and only then after it got mixed then you knew about it, so then it will be there was no Hanan, and then it will be permitted even according to the Rama. Ana me'achi meiri shenidrvu agdarot yachad kodem shenodah tarovet. Alfi ma she'ocharti sham, de'afilu lo nodah tarovet amri nechanan, v'ken lo she'ach haidina rak lach belach v'efsed merubeh. So that was the side of the shach, according to the Rama, but the shach himself, he says that it's not true. Even without no one knowing about the mixture, it becomes to be chanan. So also here it will be chanan, unless we're talking about the case of liquid and it's a big loss. Inami nafal kazayit gvina leket kaftet zeitim heter. And also if you have a kazayit of cheese that fell into 29 kazayits of permission, v'gidara acheret nafal kazayit basar le-30 zeitim shel heter, and you have in the other pot a kazayit of meat that fell into 30 kazayits of permission, ונתערבו בית התערובות הללו בשוגג, and those two mixtures got together, ומותר, that it will be permitted. זה לא שייך לומר חנן, that there's no חנן here, כיוון זה עדיין כולו יותר, because with the meat it's permitted, with the milk it's permitted, and when it gets together, So the meat and the milk got nullified. Inami nafkamina im nafal kazai dam letoch shishim kazai zaitim shel eter. And also another nafkamina, another conclusion that comes out of it. If you have a kazait of blood that fell into 60 kazaits of permission, and then you have kazait plus of forbidden fat that fell into those 61 kazaits, then צריך 60 נגד בית זיתיבי. So you don't need to have 60 to nullify those two kazaits of prohibition. אלא גם הקזית דם שנפל בראשונה, and also the first kazait of blood that fell in the beginning, מצריך לבטל החלב, joins together to nullify that prohibition of the forbidden fat. מכל זה דווקא בשני מיני איסורים שאין טעמן שווה, אבל מין אחד לעולם חוזר וניהו. So all of that is when you have the prohibition, two different kinds of prohibition. But if you have the same kind of prohibition, so even if it got nullified, when it joins together with the other mixture that have also a nullified taste of prohibition, of the same prohibition, if it is the same prohibition, so then the two measurements joins together and the prohibition wakes up to make the whole mixture to be prohibited again. Okay, that's a very, very complicated halachic calculations here. Yeah, there's a whole like discussion, there's a whole sugi about chozer v'niyor, and usually they speak about in Pesach, but here he's saying that also about other prohibitions, not only chametz in Pesach.
So isn't that similar to what we talked about before, but the Shulchan Aruch?
Similar, but a little bit different, yeah.
So what's the difference here?
That here you have 60 to nullify the first one, and they didn't fall together. In the first case, we had 59, and you have two kazaitim that fell together.
Okay.
Here you have 60, and then you had one prohibition that fell inside, got nullified, and then you had another prohibition that fell inside and got nullified. So I'm just saying like theoretically, let's say you find, I don't know how can it be, what would it be, but let's say you find like 60 and more than 60 kinds of prohibitions that each one have a different taste. Yeah. And you take a zayit of each one of them and you're throwing into that same pot. Every time you're throwing another prohibition. So you have in that pot, it becomes to be that the majority of the pot is prohibitions, but it is all permitted. Because each one of those prohibitions is nullified. Yeah, we don't do it there, obviously, lechatchila. Yeah, it's only b'dieved, not that you're throwing inside purposely. But if it happened, something like that, the result will be that you have a pot, the majority of that is prohibitions, and it is permitted. Yeah. It's interesting, interesting theory, theoretical case. Hypothetical. Hypothetical is the right word. You have a word like that in English? Hypothetical?
Hypothetical.
Okay, anyhow. Last בער היטב, כף בית, מבטל פירוש שנפלו לירקות בגדרה, דמען לכל אחד לשיעור 60. What was that about? Did you have two kazites of meat and dairy that fell into the same pot? Or, so it says here in the kafbet, in the baritim kafbet, vegetables, yeah? So each one is nullifying the other. So the, yeah? In other words, you have 59 kazites of vegetables, and then you had two kazites, one of meat and one of milk that fell inside to the same pot. So you have 60 to nullify the meat, you have 60 to nullify the milk, and it's all permitted. There's no taste of meat and dairy there. Because the meat doesn't have taste and the milk doesn't have taste. Right? Baruch Hashem. Very good. Okay, let's start Siman Tzadik Ted a little bit. First paragraph. So Siman Tzadik Ted, Dina Atzamot, Im Mitzarfin Levatel Isur, Veshelo Levatel Isur Lechatchila. Okay? So the halacha of bones, if you can calculate the bones as part of nullifying the prohibition, and the prohibition of nullifying the prohibition of nullifying prohibition purposely. Aleph. חתיכת נבלה שיש בה בשר ועצמות שנפל לגדרת היתר. You have a piece of carcass that have bones and meat that fell into a pot of permission. עצמות האיסור מצטרפים עם היתר לבטל האיסור. The bones of the prohibition joins with the permission to nullify the prohibition. Okay? ואין צריך לומר שעצמות היתר מצטרפים עם היתר. Now much more so, it's very easy for us to say that the bones of the permission will join with the permission to nullify the prohibition. אבל המוח שבעצמות איסור מצטרף עם האיסור, but the marrow of the bones of the prohibition joins together with the meat of the prohibition. Okay? וגוף הגדרה אינה מצטרפת לא עם האיסור ולא עם היתר. The volume of the pot just doesn't join together not with the permission, not with the prohibition. רמה, ויש מחמירים שלא לצרף עצמות האיסור עם היתר לבטל. במקום סד, יש לסמוך המקלים ומתירים, וכן ניכר. רמה says that there is stringent opinion that holds you cannot join together the bones of the prohibition to nullify the prohibition. But if it's a place of a big loss, you can rely on the lenient opinion and permit it. Okay? Which is the main opinion. Beritev. Okay? כתב התזלה, וזה לשונו, לפי שאינה בני אכילה. Why we say that the bones of the prohibition joins together with the permission to nullify the taste of the prohibition? Because the bones are not eatable, right? There is people that they like to eat bones. They cook the bones like for a long, long time, and then they eat the bones, not the, all the bones, but they're scraping the bones and eat like some of it. Yeah, you know that custom of some people? I know some people like that. So there is so whatever is eatable, that will be part of the prohibition. Whatever is not eatable, according to the Shulchan Aruch, can join the permission, right?
The bones is better than the meat that's on the bone.
What?
Saying like a chicken bone is better than the meat that's on the chicken.
Okay. So there you go. Mm-hmm. If the bones are eatable, so for example, chicken bones that were cooked enough, so that will be part of the prohibition if the chicken is prohibited.
Yeah.
מכל מקום בולעים הם על ידי הבישול, על כן מצטרפים לבטל האיסור. So it does absorb the taste of the prohibited meat, and that's why it can join together to nullify the taste of the prohibition. Okay, that's the explanation of the Taz. מורי וחמי, my father-in-law, says the Taz, which is, we know, Bach, הקשה על הרמה, he had a question on the רמה, מה שאמר בתורת חטאת, אפילו אחרת שבכלי צריך 60 כנגדו. The Rama says that you need to have 60 even to nullify the clay of the pot. אם כן גם כאן נעימה דעצמות נעשה נבלה. So you can say here that the bones became to be part of the prohibition. Why it is less prohibition than the pot? If the pot is absorbing and you need to have 60 to nullify the taste that was absorbed in the pot, so how much more so the bones? ואני אומר משה אמת ותורתו אמת. Yeah. The Taz is like playing with his father-in-law. His father-in-law was asking a question on the Rama. Rama, Rabbi Moshe Isserlish. He says, no, Moshe Emes and Torah so Emes. What Rama said was true. Why? בעצם זה דומה ממש לכלי מתכות, that really the bone is not like a clay pot, it's like a metal pot. What's the difference? זה לא אמרינה בחנן. Okay, so we had a whole discussion about if you say חנן so basically the Taz is explaining that here the Rama is talking about, according to the opinion, that only in a clay pot becomes to be Hanan. Okay? So why the metal pot doesn't become to be Hanan? Because the fact is, you can kosher the metal pot. The clay pot, you cannot kosher. But the metal pot, you can kosher. Anami be'etzem kumvah be'or chayim siman tafnun alef, the clay etzem nitarim be'agala. And we know in Or Chaim Siman Tafnun Aleph that vessels that made out of bone can be permitted, can be kosher, if you koshering it in boiling water. Okay, lo she'ach kan chanan ad kan leshano, and that's why it's not relevant to speak about chanan in the bones. Okay, that's the terus of the Taz. עד כאן לשנו, הרן כתב פרק יד הנשא, כאן דעצמות הרכות מצטרפים לאיסור מפני מוח שבהם ומחמת רקותן שיצא לחוט, אבל עצמות יבשים וקליפות של ביצים, כי אגב נאותן של איסור מצטרפים לבטל האיסור. Okay, so the run is saying what I was saying before, that it depends which kind of bones. If you have something that is soft, that is eatable, so then it's part of the prohibition, but if it's something that is not eatable, or for example eggshells, that is also not eatable, things like that, so then you can join the volume of that to the permission to nullify the taste of the prohibition.
Well, if the bones are edible, then it goes to what side?
Also, eggshells are also like very nutritious.
Yeah, but it's not eatable. You don't eat them. It's nutritious, but people don't eat them. It's not okay. Called powder. It's not considered to be food.
So
then it's part of the prohibition. Yeah, bones of prohibition, yeah. Bones of prohibition that are soft and you can eat them, so it's part of the prohibition.
But if it's hard,
so it can join to the permission to nullify the prohibition taste. You know, they asked Rav Moshe Feinstein Zatzal, if somebody is in the desert and the only thing that you have to eat is pig meat, so can he eat it? Otherwise he will die. So Rav Moshe Feinstein said he can eat it, but he shouldn't suck the bones.
Oh.
So there is cases that you can say that it's permitted, something is permitted, but like don't try to get like the extra geschmack, the extra like benefit of pleasure there from that whatever is permitted is permitted to survive, but not more. So also here, like to suck the bones, it's like whatever you can take out from the bones is part of the prohibition. right? בתקדרה, פירוש אותה גדרה שמבשל בה עכשיו איסור ויתר. So whatever is the pot that you're using to cook the whole mixture here. מחמירים מכל מקום, גם לאיסור אין מצטרפים, אבל עצמות היתר מצטרפים ליתר. So also for the prohibition, it will not join, but the bones of the permission for sure will join the permission, even for the Ashkenazi. Okay, we'll hold it here for today. Thank you very much. Baruch Adonai le'olam. Amen ve'amen.